You might recognize this pen. It was from a previous video on making a calligraphy nib, custom calligraphy nib. Cutting it with wire cutters and polishing it. This is the exact same pen, only it has just been filled with a new ink. You might recognize that fellow. He looked like that because he was either disgusted or despondent with what his uncle was perceived to have done. The rumor has it that 120 hunting dogs were starved in individual cages and then suddenly released upon his uncle and tore him limb from limb. The other rumor has it that his uncle was put on a three-legged stool and he kicked the stool, short stool, 6 inches or so, and watched his uncle strangle. And then the third was that his uncle was probably summarily shot. That's the type of character he is. It's the type of character his family. Dating back to his grandfather and the argument about the size and shape of the table upon which they were to negotiate an armistice, hopefully a peace treaty, but that never happened. While they were arguing about the shape of the table, thousands of Americans and Koreans died. And I think he's a stain upon the face of humanity. If you can't take my word for it, you should read the writings and the findings of a retired Australian judge by the name of Michael Kirby. I initially thought this ink project was somewhat amusing. I always knew North Korea was a problem. My dad had served in the Air Force towards the tail end of the Korean conflict, and I knew the stories, but I had no idea how badly the country had fallen off of any semblance of human decency. What they're doing to their own people, this regime, the Kim family. Just hopefully you'll read some of the links I put under this video on by Michael Kirby, the UN Commission, and by Park Sang Hak and other individuals who have escaped the gulags, the ovens, and the other unfortunate bits of information that have managed to escape from North Korea. This fellow was mentioned, this Park Sang Hak, in the Wall Street Journal, and one particular article, I had to do an ink label, and I had to do a 3 ounce bottle, and I'll read it to you. Park Sang Hak, a North Korean defector now living in the South, has an idea. Mr. Park, whom we profiled last year, puts information about the outside world, along with movies and television programs, on USB drives, which he floats into the North on balloons. The Kim Jong-un regime has labeled him Enemy Zero and sent an assassin to kill him with a poison-tipped pen. For real. You can look it up online. You look for the name Park Sang Hak, or you simply look up Kim Jong-un or North Korea and poison pen, and you'll see that there is what appears it they identified it as a Parker pen. It looks like a Sonnet or a Frontier. There's actually a fountain pen with a ball pen. The ball pen was to inject poison. The fountain pen was to shoot a poison bullet. And then they also had an LED flashlight that apparently accurately could shoot 3 rounds. This was to kill Enemy Zero. What did Enemy Zero do? Well, he's the inspiration of this label and this ink, which I've named in his honor. Of course it is red, because it is a communist regime that I can't stand, and I believe he can't stand. It's called Park Red, after his name. And the symbolism of the artwork, I'll just briefly explain. Mr. Park escaped from North Korea. I invite you to watch a video. It's linked below. He can say it best in his own words. He started with party balloons and helium. This evolved into hydrogen balloons, greenhouse bags that were giant elongated greenhouse bags, quite tall, filled with much cheaper hydrogen, capable of carrying an average 22-pound payload. He had put currency in it to get attention. He figured out certain types of plastic for printed pamphlets, make it waterproof and durable so that they would fly around North Korea and be lasting. And just in case somebody had access to a computer, and even if they didn't, he would send over radios on balloons. And this regime is so insecure, he's not Enemy One, he is famously Enemy Zero. And they wanted to use pens to assassinate him. I can't resist it. Initially, I thought it was funny, but after researching, I knew North Korea was bad. I didn't know how bad it was. Just a few key words: infanticide based on racism. A few other words: prisoners putting others in crematoria. I don't have to go on. It's not funny. It is really a shame upon humanity. But this is, Mr. Park couldn't do anything. He can't fight the 1 million strong North Korean army, but he could send balloons as a free citizen of South Korea. And it's remarkable the effect they've had. So his initial balloons, party balloons, are depicted with little USB drives. And this is Kim Jong-un in his characteristic black suit, smoking his cigar. This is his pouting face that I so impolitely drew upon. That rules out my ever visiting North Korea, I suppose. He has little feet, little hands, and this is a typical North Korean anti-aircraft gun, and he's shooting fountain pens out the barrel with little North Korean flags upon them. And occasionally he might get one, but the label wraps around, and eventually the balloons are shown in back of him. And he's never able to get rid of them all. And he's using this massive weapon against balloons. They have threatened and followed through on artillery barrages on certain South Korean locations where the balloons have been launched. They've made many threats to bomb them. And Whether the interview is a good movie or not, Mr. Park is going to send Kim Jong-un 100,000 copies of it by balloon. And this silhouette is, in Korean it says This One Earth. It's the name of the sculpture that's in front of the third tunnel of aggression. If you read up on that, you'll find that it could send about 30,000 troops into the south per hour, and they claim to be digging through solid granite to create this tunnel in order to get coal. It was a lie. There's no coal in granite. It's a sedimentary rock, and granite most decidedly is not. And they thus, when caught in this lie, painted the walls with a sort of coal tarry amalgam, which has now sort of become a tourist attraction. Under here, in Korean, is basically a direct play on the words park and red in Korean. The English title is most assuredly after Mr. Park. And on the label, you can see how the balloons eventually catch up behind Kim Jong-un. And he hates America. It's made in USA. I hope somebody sends him a bottle by balloon. I hope you hit the links, and I hope you enjoyed this little demonstration that no doubt will be yet another label that gets me a death threat, which I shall cherish, record, and pin on the wall.